phone was ringing. Somehow I knew the call was for me. Yes.
Do you know who I am?
No. Who is this?
We'll get to that later. There are spies all over. Shadows.
A sense of deja vu washed over me. Had I had this conversation before?
Alan, listen to me carefully. Caldera Street Station, the subway. You need to go there. I'll call you again later. Make sure to pick up.
Do I know you? I know you from somewhere.
You've just forgotten again. We're in this together. Don't worry. I got you now. We've been working.
I'm losing you. Hello? Hello? The man had said Caldera Street Station. I had to go there. Where I could go, and where I couldn't. Fuck. Okay, don't mind me, just passing through. The Caldera Street Station sign was there, but the entrance was missing. I had to make it appear. Maybe I could use the lamp to reveal the station entrance. The lamp was dead in my hand. I needed to find a light for it. It was locked from the other side.
Oh, no. Is this the way it was on the page?
What the hell? Oh, hey. We met at Dor's show.
Alan Wake, the writer. I'm Alex Casey, looking into a murder.
Come on, what? What is this?
There's a piece of evidence, a manuscript of a novel. You wouldn't know anything about it?
A manuscript? What manuscript? I need to see it.
Rumor had it the manuscript contained the details of the murders. A murder cult was following the story to commit their gruesome acts. Was Wake their leader? Had he written it? How far would he go to create a perfect work of art? Or would he be the next victim? Stay here.
No, wait! I need a gun!
No chance.
This was an echo of the books I had written for years. Picking up Casey's gun felt like I was assuming the role of the detective. I had a light now. I needed to get back to the subway station entrance. With the alley in darkness now, restless shadows block my way. Gun and flashlight, I could fight back. I could use the light to open the subway entrance now. I needed to find another light to go deeper inside. It could not be opened on this side. I needed to find a way around that fence. There was something hidden here. Light would reveal it.
Wake.
The door wouldn't budge. books about Alex Casey.
Tried to wash away the sins of this city. But some sins, the evidence of the crimes committed, could never be erased. Not by the rain, or any amount of therapy from Dr. Jack Daniels. It remained bruises under my skin, like tattoos. Bruises in my soul, scar tissue on my heart. The rain never stopped falling, and I never stopped drinking.
Hello.
Oh. Hey, Alan. You snuck up on me.
Sorry. Have we met?
Memory problems again, huh? Yeah, we've met. Tim Breaker. We've shared notes. Hey, I've made some progress on the map, if you want to take a look. I still haven't found my mystery man, though.
You're making a map?
Trying to. It's hard to map a dream, though. I keep ending up in unexpected places. I find interesting things like those strange markings that react to the light, but never the one thing that I'm looking for. Feel free to check the map out. Oh, I've been stockpiling supplies while I poke around. If you find a stash, take anything you need.
I appreciate the help. Who's this mystery man?
Oh, it wouldn't be much of a mystery if I knew. All I have is a name. Warland Dorr.
The talk show host?
No. No, that doesn't sound like him. The guy has many disguises, but a talk show host? I'll keep looking. Well, that's my crazy wall. I'm just trying to make sense of things. Don't judge me.
I'll trade you walls any day.
Around, Alan.
phrase repeated over and over. The words resonated with meaning. Had I written this? The gates to the platform were closed. I had a ticket. Something about the station platform felt significant. It would work in my writing, but I needed more. Something lingered here. A half-forgotten memory. An echo. Something was here. A vision about to reveal itself. I needed to look at it from the right angle.
Dots from one murder to the next, inviting me to draw an obscene picture on the city map. Caldera Street Station. The name made me think of the exit wound of a bullet.
I had a flash of inspiration. The ghost of my fictional detective. A story thread I could use in my writing. I had a location. I had a story thread. I would put them together, write them into my story to create a path deeper into the dark place. Things clicked into place. The story rang true. I was making progress. The dark place reacted to my story. The way into the tunnels was no longer blocked. The Fed had glimpsed into the Maw of Darkness. It swallowed him whole. The tracks led into the tunnel. That was my way forward. The trail continued deeper into darkness.
Alan Wake. Alan Wake.
The sound of that. The tunnels were a maze. but the blood trail led me on. Another place to use in this story. I needed to search the tunnels for further visions. Inspiration for the story that would lead me deeper. The new scene I had found was important for the story. I had changed the story, and with that, the dark place changed.
Some fed came looking for the cult, but it was a trap. A satanic blood sacrifice.
Anyone who gets involved with the cult, they're next. I heard their leader is this famous writer, Alan Wake. Their unholy motherfucking messiah.
Sounds like a load of bull.
I had to be at the scene, to see and understand it, in order to change it. Changing a plot element in a scene without being there was impossible. Another echo lingered here, a source of inspiration.
The murders in Alan Wake's crime books, that Wake was even involved somehow, under a false identity, Mr. Scratch, which is, of course, a nickname for the devil himself.
It was disturbing finding myself in the story this way, but I was desperate, and it felt right for the story.
Let me die. Wake.
Story thread. I was making my way deeper into the story. I could imagine this murder cult performing their macabre acts beyond the collapsed tunnel. The cultists laid the Casey novel onto the altar with reverence, their twisted Bible. The water was gone. The way forward was open.
Alan. Tim Breaker. In case you don't remember again.
I know, Tim. I'm remembering more now.
It's good to hear.
How's your search for Mr. Dorr going?
It's not great. This dream we're in, putting a lot of roadblocks in my way.
The sketch you have does look like the Dorr I know. The talk show host.
All I know is the Dorr has something to do with what's happening to me. And he knows that I know. He's like some sadistic mastermind torturing me.
So you think this is a dream?
I'm not ruling it out. You know, my dreams have always been incredibly vivid. They feel real until the second I wake up. In the dreams, I'm often someone else. A different person with a different name, living a different life in a different world. It's alternate realities, maybe. But certain things don't change. Like Dorr.
The train blocked my way forward, but it was here for a reason. It had a role to play. I had a new scene to use, a new setting. Anyone there? Dead.
This is where the history of the cult gets genuinely disturbing. The cultists track down the torchbearers living in the tunnels. They lock the poor folks up in a derailed subway car, douse it in gasoline. Yeah.
Charming.
It turns into a bit of a ghost story after that. They say the dark smoke from the fire still roams the tunnels searching for new victims to devour.
There are no happy endings in this city.
The story thread felt important. I could use it in one of the scenes I'd found. I had a new beat for the story. The subway car had become a burnt husk. I could get through it now.
None of this was real. It was a dream.
My path was blocked. I had to find a way through. The lights would help me. The Echoing Hall had a story to tell. I had a new idea for a scene. The hall had changed into the murder cult's hideout.
Something here that made him run scared.
Whether the cultists were close now, a dark presence rising from the depths.
A mass psychosis of stark raving lunatics. It didn't change the facts. The cult was messing with things no one should mess with.
The ritual was a vital part of the story, the key to reaching the murder site. new story beat fit the story perfectly. The plot changed the details of the world. I couldn't hear the dark presence. It was gone. The tunnel was open now. Always out there, hunting me. Closeness to home.
An FBI agent? Who are you?
What is this? Who are you?
She can hear me.
I'm Saga Anderson, FBI.
We can hear you. This is Alan Wake. I'm trapped here. The dark place. Under Cauldron Lake.
Cauldron Lake? Who are you?
I'm trying to escape. I'm making progress, but I'm in danger. The Dark Presence. Help me. Please, help me.
I could sense it. I was closer to home. Had the woman in the vision helped me somehow? Something had changed. Outside, Parliament Tower, where I had lived with Alice. It was out there, waiting for me.